Hi friends, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in the series of morning tales, which is for your banking examinations. So let's begin this series without wasting any time further. But the students who are coming for the first time, I would like them to subscribe to this channel and hit this bell notification. Also, you guys can join this Telegram group where we share free quizzes as well as resolve the queries of students. So if you have any query, don't worry, don't hassle yourself. You can join this group and ask your queries directly with your mentors. So the link is in description box below. Hurry up, you can join the group easily. So guys, this is the quote of the day. So success kya hai? Failure ke baad ka chapter. So try in whatever thing you are trying, just try, give it a try. And then even if you fail, you will succeed eventually. So give it a try, whichever thing it is, be it your examination or be it anything you are trying your hands at. So with this, let's begin the first question of the day. Which company has signed an agreement with New Space India Limited to launch the India's first private remote sensing satellite on an ISRO PSLV rocket in early 2021? So guys, as you guys know that New Space India Limited was launched in the year 2019, and the purpose for launching this organization was to promote private sector into space activities. Like we have in US, there is SpaceX organization that do so many researches, that do so many satellite launches. We have companies like Origin Space in China as well. Origin Space is not of China. I'm a little blur here, but you can check it out. But there are many private companies that are taking initiatives in various developed nations. So in order to follow the footsteps of those nations, India has also granted the private sector this access to use the satellite, to launch the satellites and to participate in the space activities. And for this, a startup has signed an agreement to launch the first ever remote sensing satellite of India, which would be manufactured by a private company. So this is the first ever private remote sensing satellite. Now, which company is it? It is Pixel. So Pixel is the company. Guys, do you know where Pixel is located? So if you don't know, then do search for it. Do mention it in the comment section below. And this reminds me to tell you guys, those who are watching this session, do mention your answers in the comment section below. It will help you in memorizing the questions later on. So do not shy or do not, do not hesitate in answering your questions, in answering the questions that I ask in the question, in this session. So that's all for this question. I hope that you have understood what I have taught you. Who has become the first Indian to win a Formula 2 race during the Sakhir Grand Prix, Bahrain? So this Sakhir Grand Prix was held in Bahrain, and this is the first Indian who has won the Formula 2. Guys, this is a type of motorsport, and we are not going to delve into the details of this kind of motorsport. Just remember this thing, that there is Formula 1 motorsport, and currently Lewis Hamilton is the, we can say, is the world champion of Formula 1 motorsport. Majority of the championships have been won by Lewis Hamilton in 2020, but I'm not saying that he is the winner of all the championships. Remember this thing. Now, in terms of Formula 2, we have a winner from India. So who is it? It is Jehan Daruwala. So he is that person who has made history by becoming the first ever Indian to win the Formula 2 race. And in which tournament has he won it? It is Sakhir Grand Prix. Remember it as well. So that's all. Let's move on to the third question. Which of the following book has won the Ben Hassel Tiltman History Prize 2020? First of all, guys, this prize is given for non-fiction works. Which organization gives this? Ben Literary Foundation. And who has won, which book has won this award? It is The Patient Assassin. And this book is written by Anita Anand. Now, an interesting fact about this book is that this book is based on Jallianwala Bagh massacre, and this book has won the 2020 Penn Hassell-Tilghman History Prize. Now, your task is to know that where is this Penn Literature Foundation located. This is not very important from your exam point of view. It is just a warm-up exercise for you guys. So if you are interested, then do find the answer of this question, that where is this organization located? Who is the business person of the year 2020 according to Fortune? So as we know that Fortune, Forbes, Times, so these are some of the magazines that release these kinds of lists regularly, or we can say on a periodic basis. So this time we have the business person of the year 2020 list. And who is that person? It is the CEO of Tesla company. So who is that person? It's Elon Musk. SpaceX guys, SpaceX bhi Elon Musk ka hi hai. Remember this thing. So Tesla CEO Elon Musk has been accredited as the business person of the year 2020 by Fortune. Now, are there any Indians on this list? Yes. Indian CEO Shantanu Narayan. Who is the CEO of Adobe company? Is at 8th rank. And Ajay Bhanga is at the 9th rank. Now, which company's CEO is he? It's Mastercard. So guys, remember these two people because they are the Indians, they are of Indian origin, who feature among the top 10. So that's all for this question. Now we are moving on to the next question. Who has been appointed as the president of FICCI for 2022-2021? So this organization is really important organization. So you remember the president of FICCI. Who is the person? It is Uday Shankar. Who among the following has been elected as the president of World Squash Federation? So it's Zena Woodridge. Which country does she belong to? She belongs to England. So remember her origin country of origin as well. Zena Woodridge has been appointed as the president of World Squash Federation. Now, are you interested to know where is this federation located? So do find it out. It is your task to find out the headquarters of this World Squash Federation. Just remember the headquarters and president. It will suffice for your preparation for majority of the banking exams. Which bank has launched an overdraft facility named as Krishi OD for farmers? So this Krishi overdraft facility has been launched for farmers in order to provide them working capital. Now which bank has done it? It is Karnataka Gramin Bank, Vikas Gramin Bank. It's option D. Now your task is to find out the tagline of this bank, because whenever we are talking about banks, three things are really important. First is the chairman or the CEO, whichever the greater post is. Second is the tagline, and third is the headquarter. Since the headquarter is in Karnataka, so tagline and chairman. These are the two static facts about this bank that you should be aware of. So do find it out that what is the tagline of this bank and what is the who is the chairman. In case you don't find the answer, then do mention it in the comment section. I will tell you the answer. Which of the following project in India has received the first ever combined sovereign and non-sovereign loan of $190 million from ADB? ADB stands for Asian Development Bank, for improving its power distribution project. So basically, power distribution services. Which of the following project, or we can say which of the following city has received this $190 million loan from Asian Development Bank? What is so special about this loan? We will discuss it later on, but first let's discuss the answer. So it is Bangalore. Bangalore Smart Energy Efficient Power Distribution Project has received this loan from ADB for improving its power distribution services. Now, what is the special thing here is The special thing here is that this is the first loan given by ADB to India, which is a combination of non-sovereign and sovereign loan. So out of this 190 million, 100 million will be guaranteed by sovereign, that is the government of India. So the 100 million will be guaranteed by government and 90 million will be non-guaranteed. So this is the speciality of this loan. Therefore, you have to remember this thing. Static facts about ADB, you should recall those static facts, because I have discussed it many times. I have asked this question many times from you guys. So now it's your turn to recall all the facts about Asian Development Bank. Establishment year, the current president, the members of ADB and the headquarters. So these are the things that you should keep reminding yourself of. Which country will host the 2021 FIFA Club World Cup? So this 2021 FIFA World Club Club World Cup will be played by 7 teams. So remember this thing. This is a basic fact. And Japan is going to host this 2021 FIFA World Cup, Club World Cup. Remember this thing, 2020 edition is going to be hosted by Qatar, but in February 2021. So in February 2021, the edition that is going to be held is of 2020. Remember, Qatar is the hosting country. So that's all for this question. I hope that you have enjoyed this session, and if you have, then do share this video with your friends as well and do subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much for watching the video.